Subscribe now, hit the notification bell, and be ready to embark on a visual adventure. The BYD Dolphin may be the least expensive battery electric vehicle at present sold in Australia, yet you'd be utterly misguided to consider it some sort of spending plan purchase offering. As the new passage in BYD's lineup here, the electric hatchback sits underneath the enormously effective ATTO 3 SUV and destined to be sent off SEAL vehicle, a radiance model for the fledgling Chinese brand and prone to turn into a serious opponent to the Tesla Model 3. And keeping in mind that some could contend Dolphin might not have the remarkable same stylish of its bigger stablemates, it's positively not ugly, particularly in the top-spec premium trim which adds the decision of four unique two-tone paints, all of which look eminent. Indeed, even the wheels look great. Elaborately, Dolphin's front and backlight marks look forefront, with drove light groups expanding the width of the vehicle. The Dolphin likewise ticks a lot of boxes with regards to space, reasonableness, solace, tech, elements and security, also a guaranteed WLTP scope of up to 427 km, alongside a lot of go-on draft. BYD's Dolphin rides on a similar versatile E-Stage 3.0 for electric vehicles utilized by its bigger kin. Purchasers get the decision of two trims and two battery measures. The BYD Dolphin Dynamic is furnished with a 44.9 kWh unit, while the BYD Dolphin Premium purposes a 60.48 kWh battery for additional power and more noteworthy reach. Curiously, BYD has likewise affirmed a Dolphin game variation in restricted numbers for 2024, estimated fundamentally higher than the superior variation tried here at just shy of $50,000, however execution yields have not been declared. From a size correlation, Dolphin extends only 3 cm longer than its MG4 opponent and expenses $100 less at the section level. First off, there's a fascinating blend of materials with regards to the lodge, positively, that stream pleasantly with a completely current subject, however with all the typically works inside simple reach of the driver. All surfaces are delicate touch or have a finished look and feel about them, yet specifically noteworthy are the inquisitively formed entryway openers on the entryway cards. They're genuine metal and hope to have been motivated by a dolphin, basically its blade or tail. Strangely, they function admirably and feel quite a bit better to the touch. The veggie lover calfskin, sea leatherette, pale seats in the Dolphin Premium tried here additionally incorporate Alcantara-like supplements, which are essentially heavenly for their solace and reinforcing. They're not sports seats, yet they're damn close and significantly, the two fronts are electrically customizable. I additionally like the look and feel of the Dolphin's three-torqued, level-based directing wheel. It's enclosed by that equivalent super delicate leatherette with a lot of usefulness with a sharp guiding manager cover for sure. There's a little 5.0-inch computerized driver's showcase mounted on the directing segment, and keeping in mind that it's respectable shows all the vital data I actually tracked down it all in all too little on occasion. Maybe that is my age appearing. The main thing you'll see, and get energized by, is BYD's spinning touchscreen which can go from scene to representation at the hint of a button on the guiding wheel. Curiously, Apple CarPlay just works in its default scene position. No big deal, however an interesting point as you get cleaner admittance to the scramble-mounted air vents when pivoted. While there's a line of round easy route buttons for any semblance of environment control, drive modes, sound volume as well as the flip shift gear selector, the vast majority of the vehicle's usefulness is gotten to through menus on the touchscreen. Dolphin purchasers would do well to get some margin to get comfortable with the environment control menu and driver help capabilities prior to going out on their underlying trip. There's a lot of highlights in the two menus and it's certainly worth requiring the investment for a profound jump. Front and center, stockpiling compartments of every kind imaginable are ample without a doubt, and on two levels, both covered and open cubby openings. There's additionally remote charging, however cell phone reflecting is wired for Apple CarPlay, but Android Auto clients get the decision of both remote and wired cell phone reflecting. and keeping in mind that it could seem to be a focal armrest serves as a control center box, it really doesn't open or I was unable to track down it. Considering the wide range of various compartments, you won't miss it the slightest bit. It looks and feels undeniably more complete, while possibly not more complex than the MG4 within and surely a more agreeable spot to be with regards to general traveler space, and that is before you get to the all-encompassing electric rooftop with auto sunblind. The back seats are similarly pretty much as agreeable as those seats front and center bar the reinforcing, however legroom is significant and the floor is level, one of the critical advantages to ground up electric vehicles. There's a focal armrest with two cup holders and a less appealing piece of backseat furniture which serves as extra cup or jug holder alongside Type-C and A USB ports, front and back. Also, there are legitimate backseat pockets and double telephone holders alongside fair width entryway containers. The boot could appear to be compromised on the off chance that you take a gander at the numbers alone, 345 litres, extending to 1,310 litres with the back seats collapsed in a 60-40 design. The boot floor can be dropped to oblige taller things, or set to similar level as the collapsed seats. It's a decent element to conceal stuff away from intrusive eyes. In spite of its moderately reduced extents, Dolphin is an extraordinary illustration of canny space bundling and more than equipped for supporting the requirements of a four-man family in solace. The boot could appear to be compromised in the event that you take a gander at the numbers alone, 345 litres, extending to 1,310 litres with the back seats collapsed in a 60-40 setup. The boot floor can be dropped to oblige taller things, or set to similar level as the collapsed seats. It's a decent element if you likewise have any desire to conceal stuff away from inquisitive eyes. Notwithstanding its moderately conservative extents, Dolphin is an extraordinary illustration of smart space bundling and more than fit for supporting the necessities of a four-man family in solace. What's under the hat? Dolphin purchasers get the decision of two unique specs, the Dynamic, which gets a solitary 70 kW/180 Nm electric engine, controlled by a 44.9 kWh battery, BYD claims 0 to 100 km per hour in 12.3 seconds. The Dolphin Premium Tri-Tier knocks it up to a 60.5 kWh battery and a 150 kW/310 Nm electric engine, further developing its 0 to 100 km per hour run by over 5 seconds to 7.0 seconds.